Iggy, creative mommy of two, and welcome. Let's move some chairs around, shall we? Doing musical chairs, but a little different. Oh, how are you all today? I hope you're doing good. I'm feeling a little meh, but yeah, as always, let's get into that in a little bit. Let's first talk about what I am working on today. In case you think it's a little bit of an odd angle today and it's a little bit dark, I'm sorry. I didn't turn my laptop on today and I'm not wanting to turn it on for just a few minutes. And my ring light is USB powered, so it needs to go on my, well, laptop. I was already lost for words. This is off to a really good start today. Well, yeah, if you're new, hi, welcome, I hope you like it. And if you're not, well, you know my rambles and stuff, so yeah, you know how I work, so yeah, it probably will not surprise you that I'm already lost for words. So yeah, I am today, as usual, at least usual for now, working on Pink Rose by Vicki Davidson, and this is available on Diamond Art Studio UK. I think that I'm about halfway with this one as soon as I finished this section I'm working on now. So this one will go a lot quicker than my last weapon chat project. But yeah, this one is a 40 by 40, so it's a little bit more doable in size. But yeah, again, I hope you had a fun week. Mine was a little bit, how would I call it? Eh? Yeah, how to start this off. If you have seen last week's Whippin' Chat, you might have known that, well, at least I think I said that I had a little bit trouble with my stomach. And yeah, that's still continuing. So last week I worked just one time in the whole week on my sneaky cat. Luckily I have enough parts already done for that time lapse, so it's not like a big problem that I'm not working on it. Because, yeah, I still have enough and I am uploading the time lapse videos just once every 2 weeks so that I have some time to complete things, and most of the times I make sure I have some, well, saved for when I am, yeah, not feeling the best, or I'm too busy, or whatever happens. But yeah, basically the reason why this is that I'm having issue with my stomach, at least what I am thinking of at this moment, I have a little bit of a medical history, let's call it like that, with my stomach, especially with my colon. I have, as we call it here, prikkelbaar darm syndrome, which is, I think you call it in English, spastic colon. The Dutch literally translates annoyed? Touchy? Like, yeah, something like that. Irritable, maybe? You get the gist. Let's call it irritable for now. Irritable colon. syndrome. Which basically for me, most of the times means that sometimes at random, but most of the times because of stress, I will have troubles with my intestines. Most of the times it means that I have a lot of cramps, some, let's call it nicely, blockage, which makes the cramping will most of the times get worse. Most of the times I can hold it pretty much under control. When I know it starts, most of the times I need to figure out what the stress causer is. So most of the times I can figure it out, but for this time, it's not, I think I know what it is. I'll tell you in just a sec, but I'm not completely sure how long this will take. Because I am thinking that it is caused by the stress that I have about my husband's surgery. If you've been here before, you probably know. Well, you most likely know because, that's most of my repeat subjects. Well, you know that my husband has a tumor that he needs to be removed, and the surgery date is November 29th, if I'm correct out of the top of my head. And numbers here are picking up pretty bad. And we are at the moment having, since last Saturday, we are having again some restrictions. So we're already fearing that in 2 weeks' time the numbers aren't low enough, and most of the times hospital cases are a bit behind. So when the regular numbers are going down, most of the times it's still 1 or 2 weeks before the hospital numbers go down. So we at this moment are fearing that he will get a call that his surgery will be postponed, and they don't know when they can do the surgeries again. And they then basically need to start over and basically see who's more top priority and start from there. So at least for me it kind of works on my nerves, because I want to have it done and dusted, especially since, as long as we can do the surgery, we can't move on with our daughter's room. So that's a little bit of an extra stress for me, at least, because I want to have a decent room for my daughter and my son, not just for one of them. Because, you might know, my son basically sleeps in the hallway. Oh well, we'll make it work some way. So I think that is my stress factor at the moment. And at the moment it also makes that my C-section scar is pretty much annoying the crap out of me. And it hurts pretty bad, I can say, but it annoys me a lot. It's not that it's like constantly hurting or something, but with moments it feels kind of painful. So I wanted to call the doctor today, but I was like ninth in the line when I called, so I was like, that ain't gonna happen today, or at least not now. And yeah, I forgot to call afterwards. That's typically me. Like, I'm really good at doing things for others. Calling like, oh, you need to call that, or I call that for you, or whatever. But as soon as it is about myself, for one or the other reason, I forget everything. Yeah. Can't help it. I'm just like that. Phew, yeah. Okay, he's okay, sorry. Needed to pause for a bit. So in case you thought that's going quiet, or in case you heard the coughing, my son has a little bit of a cold at the moment. He started coughing like yesterday evening, so yeah. But since it being the time of the year and we basically go like nowhere and we are fully vaccinated, obviously the kids aren't, but you're 1 in 3, so it can be, at least not at this moment. We don't have plans for like the next week, so we're like, we'll wait for a bit. If it's still keeping to continue, we probably need to get him tested just to be sure that it's not the annoying bug. Just to be sure, just to be safe. But at the moment, we suspect that it's just a little annoying cold. But yeah, since yeah, the whole situation, we can't go anywhere, or at least not as much as we like, so also the kids most likely have little, yeah, a little hit on their immune system, so. And it's that time of year, and yeah, the whole annoying bug is not the only bug that's running around freely, so. But yeah, he is coughing a bit. He had a fever Friday? Thursday? Somewhere in that area. He had a fever like 39 point something degrees Celsius. So he had a decent fever. But he was still, as he is, as happy as a clam. So yeah, we're not like immediately worried, but luckily most of the times he isn't coughing, so. So yeah, if you hear something in the background, that's my son. My baby monitor is standing on the dresser that is a little bit over that way. So yeah. For the rest of the week, yeah, basically during the day I try to do as much of my regular stuff as possible, as my body allowed, and if not, taking a break. And yeah, in the evening, basically, I was laying flat on the couch. So yeah, I haven't done my diamond painting as much as I want. But yeah. I'm sorry, my health goes before my diamond painting, so. Yeah, on my couch has its, it seems at such an annoying place that I can't put my bedside table on the couch and diamond paint there. So yes, either or. Yeah, since this, also my C-section scar, that is annoying me. Yeah, that is at an annoying height, so yeah. As soon as I move my leg up, it hurts, so. Or at least it annoys. It's not really like hurting, but yeah, it's annoying. Okay, since it's a October. Correct me. It is November already. Seriously, it's November. Yeah, since it's November already, Netflix is, well, putting a lot of Christmas movies, so I am binge watching those. Sometimes they are just like quote unquote bad movies, but they're enjoyable from time to time. Ooh, my cover minder popped off. But yeah, I am one that, like, when I'm in a mood for, like, yeah, silly romantic stuff, that's pretty much what I like to watch, like the comedy, romantic, or just simple romantic kind of stuff. I like it. Yeah, so Wednesday, the last couple of weeks for date night, my husband and I did games. But yeah, since sitting high up in a chair isn't the most fun, we decided to watch a movie, and we watched Enola Holmes. I need to say that was pretty enjoyable. I liked that movie a lot, and my husband was looking up stuff about the movie because he thought he knew the actress, but she just looked like somebody. And like that, he saw that there is an Enola Holmes 2 coming, so yay! I'm excited about that because it was a fun movie. And yeah, this Wednesday we are going to watch, oh, what's the new Marvel film called? It's the one just released on Disney Plus. Shang-Li, if I'm not mistaken. So that will be, yeah, when I upload this, because yeah, you know me, you know that I film on a Monday. Just to give myself some wiggle room. 6:45. So yeah, we're going to watch that one on Wednesday. I am planning on baking some cupcakes with my daughter this week. Basically, it is me weighing off all the ingredients, her throwing them all in a bowl, and holding the mixer together. Might be that I use my KitchenAid, in that case she will turn it on and off. But I might use my hand mixer just so she can do more, because she likes it, and yeah, it keeps her busy. I plan on doing at least some baking this week. Not planning to do anything for the Etsy shop, because yeah, that's not going too terribly well. And I am not planning on making like 200 cover minders and keychains and whatever all if I am just selling one a year. So again, little plug-in for my Etsy shop. If you would like something and you see something you like but not in the right color or anything, just let me know and I make sure it is available in the right color for you. So yeah. But yeah, maybe after Christmas, so yeah, Christmas is an expensive time, especially if you have kids. And here in the Netherlands we also have Santa Claus, which is also in December. And yeah, that whole craziness started last weekend. So basically it's like a 3 week month kinda thing. Kids just today put out their shoe for the first time. So as soon as I'm done filming, I need to wrap some shoe presents. Basically the same like hanging your stocking like this some days before Christmas. Again, just like a small present in it. But yeah, I need to wrap some stuff up and get that in there, some treats for them. So that they're all happy when they're waking up tomorrow. And what else do I need to do in the week, this week? Well, I do need to test out my new dryer. We got our new dryer in today. So probably tomorrow or the day after, I'm putting in the first loads and see how well it works. Hopefully it does well, but yeah, no guarantees made. But also, yeah, tomorrow we get in some shopping. My husband and I treated ourselves Saturday. Yeah, Saturday morning when the kids were in the tub. We have my son's room basically like straight across the hall from our bathroom. So when they are in the tub, we can sit on the chair, the floor, whatever there, and be close enough that if something happens, we're straight there, but we don't need to sit on the bathroom floor. So my husband pulled out his laptop and we went clothes shopping online, because he and I both need some new clothes. If you've watched my last week's video, you know I've thrown out quite a bit. Don't know if I said how much, but I've thrown out 3 garbage bags full of clothes that I either didn't worn for a few years or didn't fit or were just terrible. Some were stained or whatever, had holes in them. So I was like, yeah, let's not wear them again now. So yeah, I basically needed to, I actually just need to buy like a whole new wardrobe, but I'm the one, I don't want to spend like 300 euros, if not more, all in once. And I most of the time hate shopping for myself anyway, because I have a pretty specific style. I'm pretty much a jeans and t-shirt kind of girl. But I also have a strange size. I have pretty long legs and I have also pretty wide hips. And that also was said to me when I went for my wedding dress shopping. They were happy with it and I was happy that it for once wasn't annoying. Because apparently a wedding dress you like basically carry on top of your hips. Oh, with me having wide hips, I had quite some carrying space. But yeah, that makes most of the times that when I wear a dress and the like waistline is too high up, I look pregnant. And obviously with not me being pregnant, I don't want to look that. So yeah, most of the times anyway, dresses look weird on me. Also like busy patterns look strange on me. And yeah, let's basically say me and most of the clothes that are in their regular, not too expensive kind of stores are not, either not my style or not my fit. So yeah, being skinny doesn't always make shopping more easy. But yeah, so we got some stuff online, like hopefully there's something in there that fits me, my style. Otherwise I just need to send it back, but I actually just hate it. Excuse me. And for rest, Saturday with our daughter, we did watch the Intocht van Sinterklaas, which is basically like Sinterklaas coming to the Netherlands. And after that, we went to my cousin and his now fiance. I've never been to to their house, and they're already living there for almost 2 years. They like basically moved in there basically right before the whole annoying bug hit the country, which was nice for them because their previous apartment was a lot smaller, so now they had some space to move around each other so they wouldn't go stir crazy from each other. And luckily my cousin has like if I'm not mistaken, he works like in the transport sector, so he plans like trucks and stuff moving from left to right. So yeah, that's one of the essential, or basically essential jobs. So at least he could go into work, luckily, so they wouldn't like constantly be around each other and driving each other mad. So yeah, we went there. He was still proudly displaying the diamond painting I made for him like a couple of years ago, which was fun. But I already told his girlfriend / fiance that it will be replaced. He's a huge fan of Harry Potter, and yeah. If you know Diamond Art Club, you might know that there are at least Harry Potter diamond paintings in the making. I have like no clue when they come, but they already told like they can pick out one that they will have like as their presents, or at least that he got as a present, or I got some tea because she drinks loads of tea just like me. I introduced her to a company a couple of years ago, and yeah, she was like, hey, if you want some ideas, you can order me like this or that. The amounts, I don't care. These are the ones I like, these are the ones I am wanting to try. So they have like these one kettle test bags. So I got her those a few bigger bags and stuff. Yeah, so we're waiting on the Harry Potter releases so that I can show them to her, like, which do you think he likes the most? I'm like, if he wants more, that's okay. But he paid them himself. Because they're too expensive to give like 10 of them. If she's on board with it, I can say that they both each get like a diamond painting for their wedding gift. But she doesn't need to expect from me that I will do 10 diamond paintings as a gift. That will be a little bit too expensive. Fun to do though, but yeah, a bit expensive. And I already bought 3 diamond paintings again for myself. Because, yeah, you might have known, if you're a fan of Diamond Art Club, they had like a, I believe, Thankful Thursday kind of. Tuesday. Thankful Tuesday promotion that was buy 2, get 1 free. So my husband was like, you know what? Do it. Order. You already thought that I would order sooner because, yeah, my last order was in what? March, I thought I saw. So, yeah. But again, I said this before, I am trying to keep my stock like a little bit manageable so I can also get some finished. So yeah, there will be 3 in. I think they will be here like the end this week, maybe next week. Depends a bit on how all will go. In case you heard that noise, that was our neighbor. He coughs like extremely loud. He's an older man, but he coughs loud. Really loud. But yeah, as I was saying, like, it will be in, I think, latest next week. So I think The Friday of next week, I will have the first unboxing up. I will split them up in like each diamond painting its own video as usual. Just to spread it out a bit and not like have 1 hour long video and then nothing for months. I actually wanted to buy one of the early Black Friday deals they had last week. But I decided that I wouldn't do it because there was just one that I wanted. So I either took part of the sale and paid shipping and stuff, or got another one and paid that full price while the price off wasn't actually like okay for that. So I thought, like, you know what, if I'm not liking anything, if there are more like Black Friday deals stuff going on, I might do that in the beginning of the year. Because I also have some other companies that I'm wanting to buy from, so I have enough on my wish list. And not enough money to buy them all. But yeah, let's see how long I'm rambling, because I think it's long. 31 minutes again. But yeah, if you're here and you watch this long, you know I'm rambly. Sorry, can't help it. I am this way in real life, so if you know me in real life, and you know my family or friends, everyone says I talk too much. So yeah. But I think that's a family thing, because my dad always says that I talk too much, but he can for sure talk as well. And my grandma was even worse. I love the lady, but she can talk. You could easily be on the phone with her for an hour and said like 3 things. But I love the woman. Sad that she isn't around anymore, but yeah. That's the annoying thing about life. Can't always decide which family members you want to keep around longer. But yeah, I think I am done for today. I will finish this section off some other time. And yeah, I'm going to wrap some presents and put them in, I think, rather under the shoes from my kids, because they're small feet, so yeah. They're a 1 year old and 3 year old, so they don't have like my shoe size. That would be a lot easier to fit stuff in, but hey ho. But yeah. Again, this is all for this week's video. If you have something you want me to know, just want to say to me, you can leave it down in the comment section below, or you can message me on Facebook or by email. Both of them will be linked in the description box down below. There you can also find a link to this diamond painting, which, at least up to this point, I love working on. And you can also there find my Etsy shop, where you can find, for instance, let's make sure I have the view. There. This cute little cover minder. I'm seeing now if I have... Oh, I have it completely off. The... I thought like, hey, I have a magnet extra, but I just pulled it from underneath the canvas. Sometimes I'm not the smartest one here. But yeah. So yeah, you can find stuff like that, or dominoes, or keychains, or whatever. So if you would like to snoop around a bit, go visit there. And yeah, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. And if you like this video, give this a thumbs up. There are thumbs there. I was looking like, where are those? What direction am I filming? Yeah, you know, I'm not always the best at filming, but you probably guessed that by now. But yeah, I'm gonna let you go now, because I otherwise keep telling I'm gonna go for 20 minutes. I hope you liked this video. If you did, well, you know the drill. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.